Well, that was fun to get to see the technology in action. I always love getting to use it, and you know, parallel parking is always a tough thing to do.
Exactly.
So I'm happy to allow the car to do it for me.
Exactly, and I would also always avoid parallel parking, right? And it's also interesting to see how TI technology has enabled that feature, right?
Right.
So it's a cool feature.
Yeah, and isn't it fun? I mean, you can see here we've got a lot of these different features that are starting to show now. You've got the lane keeping, and you know, some of this stuff where you can actually see it navigating on the road. It's just incredible from like a usability and just accessibility of this technology in the car now.
Exactly.
I love seeing it get more and more widely adopted.
Exactly. I think one of the other cool features that I have on my car as well, and that I always use, is this collision assist, or I think it's
right.
Also AEB. So, you know, it just helps me to, you know, stop the car when it sees something is actually stopped in front of me.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think the safety opportunity with all of the new advancements and better sensing, and again, just the usability of the technology that we're enabling is really going to be it's going to be game changing, I think, for the industry, right? And for consumers, most importantly.
Exactly. I think the other trend that we've also seen is the level of autonomy, right? When we start look at, you know, level 2 going to level 2 plus, level 3 and going all the way up to level 5, I think it's interesting to see how the number of sensors are increasing for each of these levels, right? We have seen, especially on the radar sensor, we have seen 3 radar sensors, you know, 2 corners and 1 in the front, becoming 5 radar sensors, 4 corners and 1 front.
Right.
And then going up to, whether it's level 3 and above, it's going up to 7 to 9 sensors.
Mm-hmm.
And also the front radar is also becoming more like an imaging radar or high resolution radar to help with the highway pilot, especially to avoid any static, to resolve some of the static scenarios.
Yeah, and it's the same on the vision side. You know, again, we're bringing all this sensor data into the processors. And I think as we see the number of cameras increasing on the car, like you said, with, you know, L2 plus, L3, you know, everything is just all about spatial awareness. And again, the longer distances when we add in the radar capability. And I mean, even with LiDAR technology coming into play, again, the multi-sensor and the sensor fusion clearly will continue to become a bigger part of what we're doing. And, you know, the other side of it too, and you know, I know this is something on the radar side you guys also have, is this trend towards the software-defined vehicle, more connectivity through the car and the ability to do over-the-air updates and just continue to get this technology more and more pervasive in the industry.
Exactly. I think it's interesting to see, now we've talked about the trend, but I think it's also interesting to see how TI technology across all our portfolio, how it's enabling this trend and preparing ourselves in terms of helping our customers, our, you know, tier ones as well as OEMs to get there, right? So when I look at the radar, we have a scalable portfolio that addresses the corner radar, addresses the front radar, whether it is the LRR or even the imaging radar, as well as, you know, some of the smallest sensors that we have seen for side radars or even the parking also. I think to complement, we have also seen our, safety PMIC solutions. As well as the interfaces like Ethernet and FPD link to send the data to the central ECU.
Yep.
Maybe you also have a scalable
portfolio
in
the
processor side.
Portfolio. It's the scalability is really important on the processor side as well, because it allows us to get into a much broader segment of the car market. You know, it's great to see it on the premium side, and you know, that's something we've seen for a while, but now seeing it come into more and more of the mainstream vehicles is really good too. And then, I mean, the only other thing too that's been a big thing for us that we've been dealing with more and more is, you know, again, the autonomy levels go up, and as there's more features and higher expectation of the car, the functional safety overall is a big part of all, you know, a lot of our conversations. And that's both, you know, inside of the processors, inside of the TI devices, whether the safety PMIC, you know, the CERTs, I'm sure even in the radars, it's the same. And I mean, it's really cool to see, but you know, you have to have it be both safe and reliable and comfortable.
Exactly. I think to add to that as well, you know, we have this regulations, right, to support that trend. So we have, regional regulations, Euro NCAP, China NCAP, or even in US, we have this, just last year, they rolled out this FMVSS 127.
Mm-hmm.
The AEB function used to be a luxury function, and now they're making it standard or mandatory 2029 onwards. AEB and pedestrian AEB, because mm-hmm. this is basically to make sure that, you know, you can, the car can drive, be driven safely.
Yeah.
And it's also interesting to see how these technologies are supporting, and we are prepared to support the trend.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm sure on the processor side, you have the scalable portfolio as well.
Same on the processor side. Yeah, we need to make sure we're enabling, you know, everything from entry cars up through the premium segment. So it's a lot of fun to get to engage across that, yeah. that broad of the spectrum. And I agree with you. I think the regulations and all this, it's just going to make people that much more comfortable
exactly.
With the technology as it becomes more of a part of our daily life.
Yeah, yeah. I think that's we talked about all the trend and the TI technology, how it enables. So maybe it's time for us to go to the next meeting.
Yeah, sounds good.